All right, here we go. Hi, I'm David Lyle, and welcome back to the Informatica Chalk Talk series. We read every day in the media that data is the difference between winners and losers. We're reading about that all the time. So how can you, with your organization, take it to another level so that you can be the ones that are those success stories? Because it's not easy, right? In the dozens of companies that I talk to each quarter, it seems like the problem is still the same as it's been for decades, which is IT cannot move at the speed of the business. And usually the problem is due to the real detailed complexity, the hairball that's developed over time that makes it really challenging for IT to support the business at the speed that the business wants. So, what can we do to help solve that problem? What can we do to align ourselves to the business more effectively and work more quickly to meet their needs? Integration is the key, and integration really means agreement about the data. We can't do analytics unless we have agreement and about the data. If the data doesn't match when we're joining data sets together in a big data world, well, the analytics aren't going to work. So integration is the key. Now, this is a competency that we need to look at as something that we're continually improving, because typically when we do big IT projects that involve data, a lot of times we assign people to do the development or the integration aspect of the problem, and then as soon as the project is over, those people disperse to other things, and we lose all that institutional learning, all those skills that they developed. And we end up using different tools because people bring different things to the table to solve a problem. So we're not really building our integration competency by creating a kind of center of excellence or integration competency center that allows us to provide a service and do integration better for the rest of the organization, to use that as a foundation for building towards an information competency where we're developing and delivering that data to the business at the speed that the business wants, so they're really driving things. And then ultimately to a business transformation competency where the executives, it's working at the speed they want. So this all comes from a foundation of integration competency, with metadata management being the foundation to that, and I'll talk about that, I'm sure, in another Chalk Talk. But how do I assess where I am? How do I know how to get from to develop these competencies and improve upon them to move towards my future state? Getting the business and IT aligned to take advantage of these improvements is something that we found to be very challenging at most companies. So what we've done is a number of us that have a great deal of experience working with dozens and dozens of different companies have put together an assessment where we look at where you are in terms of a maturity model. But we've done something a little different here because there are a lot of assessments out there. Everybody's seen them. But I think we've got something that's special from the standpoint that it's been done by people like that you've heard of and worked with before, not just from Informatica, but outside of Informatica. Rob Carroll, John Schmidt, myself, and others have taken decades of experience and put them into these assessments that help us identify where you are in terms of the maturity of yourselves. But we take this another level, and this is where I think this is really helpful, is along these different points in the spider diagram, whether it's your culture, your infrastructure, the people, the process, or leadership, we look at where the business is with respect to your maturity, and we also look at where IT is with respect to your maturity. This is really important because when there's a difference between maturity levels between business and IT, well, that can give you different starting points as to what to do next, how to improve yourselves and give yourselves a roadmap for how to get from your current state to your future state. And that's always the hardest problem, right? It's easy to draw future state architecture. It's really difficult to know what are the steps I need to take in order to get there. And that's what's really cool about this assessment, is that by looking at the alignment between business and IT along these five different axes, we're able to diagnose and provide some pointers as to what to do first, second, third, and so forth. You'll notice that I haven't mentioned technology at all. And that's because technology is really the easy part, and the people in the process, that's the hard part. And we found this time and time again, that organizations were able to create a nice future state picture, but the problem was getting from the current state to the future state, and they continually needed help. And what happened was we actually ran into the same company and working with the same approach and architecture to solve it. And 2 years ago, we did something that we haven't told people about, but because you're in on this Chalk Talk and amongst us enterprise architects, I'll let you know about, and that's that we bought a company that had reference models and a full meta model and methodology for different vertical industries that allowed us to be able to map the business to IT and business strategy all the way down through the functions into the systems and technology, so that we could see, similar to the way we see in Metadata Manager, how I can change a report in a BI tool and how that affects the ETL and database and so forth, that I can see that impact analysis of business strategy all the way down to the systems, or if I'm changing the systems and moving technology to the cloud, what are the different organization, people, and process aspects that are going to be affected by this? And where this is really helpful for enterprise architects is doing architecture-led planning. Doing successful planning so you're understanding all the different things you need to take into account to do the plan successfully. So all this is about us being able to deliver for analytics or other purposes data to the business at the speed that they want. Data is really what determines the winners and the losers now in as a major component of business. And this is something that I think has been shown to be very helpful. So you can tell I'm pretty passionate about this particular area. So I'd love to talk about this for hours and hours. So please, below, if you've got questions or you want to talk and have more dialogue on this, please enter in the comments below. But hopefully you find this helpful and we can continue sharing knowledge together. Please, if you find this interesting, check out some of the other Chalk Talks. And anyway, thank you so much.